So I'm Dr. Dineshani Hettiarrachchi. I'm a lecturer at the Human Genetics Unit and the Department of Anatomy at the Faculty of Medicine, University of Colombo. So rare diseases are diseases that affect a small population of people in the world. Different countries have different definitions. For example, in the US, they say a rare disease is one that affects less than 200,000 people. But in the UK, they say it's 1 in 2,000 people. So in my opinion, a rare disease is something that does not fit the norm. So any condition that is not usually seen should be considered a rare disease unless until proven otherwise. So we have seen a wide variety of cases. For example, I have seen people with very lax skin, and we have had a child who does not have external ears. Then there's a family that has like four fingers, four toes, entire family member, all the family members have had that. And we've had patients who age very rapidly. And there are patients who've come with very high cholesterol levels, that if we draw the blood, the serum looks like milk. So there have been very high cholesterol levels. So these are some of the cases that we see, a wide variety of cases like this. So rare disease is generally estimated to affect 1 in 13 people worldwide. So in that context, in Sri Lanka, I would say about 2.6 million people suffer from a rare disease. Even though these diseases are individually rare, when we take all the rare diseases together, there are about 7,000 rare diseases. So it's a huge burden on the healthcare system, because these patients need to be tested and treated. So the amounts are large. A majority of the rare diseases are genetic, but there are few diseases such as some autoimmune diseases, some rare forms of cancer, and some rare infections that I would say does not have a genetic etiology. But majority, I would say 80% of these diseases has a genetic basis for it. When you look at the world today, there is a lot of evidence that suggests that we need to create more awareness among rare diseases. One thing is because these diseases can be inherited. So if you look at a family, they would start with two or three cases of these conditions. And when they come down the line, especially when they come towards the second and third generation, there are 5 to 10 patients that might be affected with this disease, and that is mainly because there is lack of awareness regarding these conditions, and also because there's lack of awareness, they don't get diagnosed properly. So these patients go from pillar to post, they go from doctor to doctor, and in the end they end up in the genetics clinic as the last resort, which should not be the case. So if there is awareness that these conditions can be inherited and has a genetic etiology, they would be referred to us and they would be tested very early on, which would benefit them, because in cases of rare diseases, getting a diagnosis is the first step. Once they have the diagnosis, then we can look at treatment options. Then we can look at what is currently being done for that disease, especially clinical trials, if we can try a new drug in those patients. So that's why it's very important to create awareness about rare diseases. And also, these rare disease testing is very costly. So to fund these tests, we need more funding, and more funding agencies usually give funds depending on how many diseases there are in the world. So by creating why it's important to test these diseases plus do research on them, I think we are not only benefiting these patients but also the mankind. Because if you look at rare diseases, I would describe them as if you take the common diseases and if you put it into a normal distribution, I would say rare diseases are on the opposite spectrum of these normal diseases. For example, if I say balding is very common to everybody, and if you take the two opposite spectrum of this condition, balding, in one end we can get a condition called alopecia universalis, where there are no hair cells at all in that patient, right? And on the other end, there is a disease called werewolf disease, where that entire person is covered with hair. So if you look at these two conditions, by studying these two conditions, we might be able to come up with mostly new technology plus most new drugs to treat something very common as balding. And if you take aging, everybody ages, right? So if you take aging and if you look at the other two spectrums, in one end we get a disease called progeria, where there are patients who age very rapidly, and this at a 14 year old might even look like an 8 year old. And on the other end of the spectrum, there is a condition where they don't age, and when a 16 year old looks like an infant. So by studying these two conditions, we can come to conclusions about something very commonly experienced by a lot of people. So that is why we need to create awareness that this research is very important, especially rare disease research. So Human Genetics Unit was established in 1983 under the patronage of Vidya Jyoti, Professor Rohan Jayasekara. He was the founder director for a long time, and now the director is Vidya Jyoti, Professor Vajiran H.W. Disanayake. You can go to our website. We have a phone number. You can call us, make an appointment and come see us.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. To keep up with the Pulse of Sri Lanka, you can subscribe to our channel here. To catch our latest videos, you can click here and here. Keep living it.